Johnson City, Tennessee Strip Club.
Strip club around Johnson City. Here you go.
Yeah, it's kind of my fault because I had to go to the hospital last night. Didn't want to, but I wasn't taking no fucking chances. And it's like a how you take your left hand and pinch your right hand kind of hard. It kind of felt that around the heart area, and it was doing that all day. I'm like, uh-oh. I was trying to ignore it, and it kept on going, because, you know, I had that fucking heart attack, and unfortunately, I died for a little bit. Kind of got paranoid. I'm like, what do I do? Fuck it, I'm going to the hospital. You know, just to make sure. And they said, nope, everything's fine. I was like, oh, okay, good, you know, I feel like an idiot. And they're like, don't feel like an idiot. I said, well, I kind of died on the 14th, and, you know, ever since then, I'm kind of like, what the fuck? What the fuck was that? It was like, yeah, we can understand. Yeah. The cute little nurse, like, I can understand you being nervous. No, honey, that's not nervous. That's paranoid. She started giggling. Oh. Mm-hmm. And plus with my military background, PTSD, depression, anxiety, it's like, oh shit, I better not fucking die. Oh God. Are you better now? I was going to tell you what time I got out. You were talking, so I just kind of hushed up and let you talk. Yeah, I got out at 7, 8 o'clock, and the people I tried to get a hold of weren't answering or just like, man, it's too early in the morning. I'm like, okay, next time you need me, go fuck yourself. And that's not an... Yeah. Well, then I told Jonathan I'm out because, you know, he asked me. He's like, you know, let me know when you're out. I said, okay. He's like, you got a ride? I was like, oh, everybody I asked kind of said, fuck you. So he came and got me and fucking hardcore grateful as fuck that he did. Oh, you have no idea how much it fucking meant to me. And, well, while I was in the hospital, I checked my card info, and that $1,400 is pending, so I'll probably get it Monday. So I just took $10, said, you need gas? And he kind of sheepishly got around the ballpark of it, and I was like, okay, yeah, you need gas. Just go somewhere, and I'll get you 10 in gas. Well, that's what I did last time, you know, like with the food stamps and shit, you know, I bought them steak, pizzas, Mountain Dew, L8s, you know, it's my way of paying back, because, you know, money's, you know, it's America, you know, money's kind of tight right now, and... Well, that's another thing I was telling Jonathan. I was like, well, you know, if I ever won the lottery, you know, it's not going to get to my head or anything. You know, I'll just take care of the people that took care of me and everybody else. And be like, fuck you. And I ain't going to buy no house. It'd be like, you know, I'll find me a nice place. And I'll go, okay, here's a year's rent up front. I won the lottery. Leave me the fuck alone. I want peace and quiet and a nice living place if I like it. Hey, I'll pay another fucking year. So, yeah, I want that kind of relationship. And I already told John, I said, hell, I'll slip you some money. Because, you know, if I won the lottery, what the fuck am I going to do with all that money? I'll find people that are really good to me and say, here's some money. What's this for? For not being a fucking douchebag, dumbass. Yeah. Yeah, I was telling Robert how I kind of felt like shit for getting a hold of you this morning to come and get me. But, like, he did, and I'm like, fuck it. I'm like, oh, hardcore grateful doesn't even begin to start it. See, I talk good about you, Jonathan, sometimes. But...
He actually put gas in the car, too.
Well, yeah.
Too. I didn't ask him for it, either.
Well, I gave you, like, $3 and quarters, too, so I'm like, here. Well, I'm getting that $1,500, so I don't need the money anymore, so it's like, here.
Well, the main thing is now when he gets that money, here about a day or so, he can go buy about 20 cartons of cigarettes.
No, I'm on the verge of quitting. I like to actually quit.
But then what y'all do if you want to quit, switch over to vaping, get you off the cigarettes for a little while. And the difference between cigarette and vaping, cigarette makes your lungs black. Vaping makes your lungs clear, but still vaping good for you, but it'll help you to get off the cigarettes.
No, that's the thing. With nicotine patches, it makes me want a cigarette like 100 times worse. And plus it makes my arm tingle.
Well, vaping has nicotine in it. You can get non-nicotine, but when it says non-nicotine, it has nicotine in it no matter what. But what I'll do is, since you're like a heavy smoker, to start with, to get you a nicotine-free, that doesn't satisfy you right by the time you finish the bottle, you get nicotine-6. And nicotine-6 don't satisfy you, then the farthest you can go is 12. But 12 is too hard on me. It burns the fuck out of my lungs.
Hey, Jonathan. I'm looking at the strip club here. They're closed on Mondays. So Tuesday through Saturday, they're open. Well, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, they're open from 9 to 1. Friday, 10 to 2. And Saturday, 10 to 2. But
I'm going to be honest with you. I want you to take your money and use it for yourself. To me, I still clean teeth my whole life. When I was in Guatemala, I lived beside this hotel. And a man will fuck with the prostitutes over there, and they don't pay a prostitute. And then you all see the prostitutes come out with machetes and their boobs all slagging everywhere. Actually, on beach where I see naked ladies running on beach, that's Indians over there. It ain't like I've seen John and Harry Bush before. It ain't like I fucked them before. So, and then not only that, no matter if you're our believer or non-believer, it's not Christian-like for me to go to a strip club, dude.
So you don't want to go?
I don't want to go. I love to go, but I don't want to go. To me, it's a Christian believer. I'm not the perfect Christian at all, but it's just
it's not
like Hooters, I don't care to go. I've never been to Hooters. Hooters is where Toddies and Whiteys
the only difference between Hooters and a fucking strip club is you get to eat better food and you leave. That's about the only difference.
Oh, you mean eating up pussy?
Dude, man, last week you're all over about going to a strip club. Now you're like, eh. I'm like, oh man, I had this all fucking planned out and everything.
You talk about yourself struggling and shit, man, and you talk about finding a place maybe, and you know, I took that money either wisely, and
I've already done that. I've already set back $1,000.
All right, so there's about 400. That's 400 that you can actually do something with.
Yeah, and I planned on it, but now you're being a little chicken on me, and
it's just the way I believe in. I mean, everybody's not perfect, you know.
You weren't that way last week.
I know that. I was going along with it, but I just start thinking about it. I just don't feel like it's the right thing for me to do, so.
God damn it.
You. But you never got your dick wet yet, man, so how you not?
Oh. No, it ain't.
Well, that's the reason why you bring a air pump with you. Pump it by your hand and catch it to her fucking ass that blowed up. But, I was gonna say, I'll let you know, see if I go, okay? I'm not saying I won't go, I might go, it's just the way I feel about it, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's either you're a believer or non-believer, but non-believers don't understand, but believers do, and...
Well, Jesus was running around with a whore, so that's self-explanatory right there. Yeah, so ain't nobody perfect. That means you can walk into a strip club, those you don't, you know, sit there and, like, actually fuck the girl right on the spot, you know, you're good.
I give you a sample, too. It's like, say something like, hey, this girl fucked Jonathan. And Jonathan ain't want to go have sex, whatever. But that's kind of hard to say no to it, you know, but it's not Christian like either. But hey, if you fucking horny as fuck and you gotta go, go. Well, I'm gonna put it this way, man. Okay, you got Christians out here that have sex before marriage. I just feel like you gotta think about Jesus' time, okay? And look at all the wives, and we gotta have like four or five wives or whatever. And back in the day, they didn't have to go court or get married and go courthouse to register marriage. You know, if you was married, you was married by heart. So I just look at it like, if you find love, whatever, and you like her, and you're not married, just give it a try. Because you got this thing, man. You can get married, you never had sex, and it'd be your first time having a sex experience. Maybe she might not like you and say, fuck you, I'm divorcing you. So what's the point of that, you know? So if you're going to have sex the first time and you have sex before marriage, then you might as well say, just see how it feels and how it goes from there, you know, and she's worth staying with you. Yeah, let's get married, if I look at it. He wants a park cart.
Yeah, but it doesn't hurt to go out and just go, you know what, just, you know, live a little, man. It doesn't hurt.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if you know about that.
Yeah, it's your mentality. I mean, like me, I've actually died several times in the Army, and here I actually died. You know, if you gone through what I went through, you'd be like, okay, life's a little too fucking fragile and a little too fucking short. You better go live a little. Yeah, you can ask for forgiveness later, but you gotta enjoy life. It's not like you're going to a strip club and go, I'm gonna fuck that, I'm gonna fuck that, I'm gonna fuck that.
No, you want to.
Well, that's the idea. You got to live a little. Because I understand the Christian thing. I understand it because I was a Christian pretty much all my life. But you're also human too. You know, you can't sit there and act like a nun or a pope, priest, whatever. Yeah, all you're going to do is torture yourself, and you're going to be depressed and lonely, and that ain't living life.
Well, flesh is the sin part, you know, and inside the soul, when we've been baptized and saved, it's already saved, so it's not touchable, but it's just where you feel the guilty in your heart, and you just feel bad at something that you did that you shouldn't have done. Later on, you learn on saying, fuck it.
I was saved and baptized at 12 or 13, so there's been many times where I go, you know what? I shouldn't have done that. I'm sorry. And then my mental mindset was, okay, I didn't like that experience. I'm not going to do it again. And let's say if you go there and you had the time of your life, and then the next day you're like, dude, I shouldn't have done that. You know, I got regret. I'm like, well, yes and no. You're still young. It's like, dude, you're still young. Live a little. But you got to learn, too. You got to learn. It's like, okay, I had fun, but I know my limits, so therefore I didn't cross my limits. You know, you
it's
can't
like
be...
watch porn.
Yeah, you can't be too... Yeah, if you watch porn, going to a strip club is no different.
Yeah, I agree.
But, you know, just go ahead. The only thing I want you to do, because you've been a good friend to me, I was going to fill up your tank, I was going to feed you, you know, grab like a little small six-pack of beer somewhere, we'll split that, and just enjoy life for at least a day, because... You know, like
that's
me.
Fine.
Yeah, because like,
because
God forbid you hit, you know, my condition or your depression kicks into the point where you don't do jack shit for 6 months. You know, you don't want to have any fucking regrets going, hey, what if?
Yeah. I had a higher experience for life. I see my body when I die in my sleep.
Okay, I'll make a deal with you. I'll pay for it also. You know, I'm not going to worry about that because I already got
I'm not backing out. I'll go for it.
I mean, I already got my bills pre-planned. I'm actually going to pay a month ahead of rent, which is going to put me in good standings for next month. And you know, I got all that covered. You know, I'm going to pay for it all. You've been a good friend. Fill up your gas tank to and from, feed you and everything. If we walk in that strip club and we're there half hour, whatever, and you're like, eh, I ain't feeling it, we'll go. You know, even though if I'm going, woohoo, and you're going, man, I ain't feeling it, I'll stop what I'm doing. I'm like, all right, you're not feeling it, we'll go.
Oh, come on, getting a six pack, though. It takes me really to get drunk, so I have one, but I ain't doubling the beer, dude. That's all I gotta say. I don't want to fucking get drunk and get a DUI, dude.
Oh, no, I'll make damn sure that doesn't happen. Because, you know, worst case scenario, if you're like, all right, you had three beers, like, okay, I'm a little drunk. You know, I'll take over to IHOP or wherever. Shit, I'll fucking drive it. And I'll go, okay, we're going to pull over here. We're going to get something to eat. And when you feel good, we'll head back to the house. Not a big deal.
Well, I was just saying, it takes me a lot longer to fucking sober up.
Well, I ain't going to let you do anything stupid by any of the means, you know. Exactly. I mean,
I just get fucking coke or something.
I mean, worst case scenario, if you get fucking hammered, I'll find out where the nearest motel is, and I'll get two rooms. So here, sleep, bitch.
Can't do that either. I got fucking dogs.
Well, that's why Devin will be home.
Can I say something real quick?
Yeah.
I have to whisper it.
Oh, Devin wants to get a baby hug and shit. Ain't never got a crutch. He's walking around on crutch now. But the thing is, he's too pussy-fied and baby-fied with that fucking ankle.
Well, I can understand a little bit of paranoia, but, you know.
Well, my mom already bitched him out over it. I had to. Trying to get off of it.
Yeah, Devin will do that sometimes. He'll kind of, like, see how far he can go with it.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not trying to bash the guy. I mean, I love Devin to pieces, too, but I've known him for six and a half years, and, yeah, I know what he can do.
But the main thing is, you know, it's like if I might drink one... And then I waited another hour and then drank two. That'd be my two beers I had. And that's it. I cut my limb off. And I said, I'm not going to drink. I don't like nobody forced me to drink. Unless I drink, you know, on my occasion. I just don't want to be forced to drink. But
oh, no, I ain't going to force you. That's why I was like, you know, get like a little four pack or hell, it worst case scenario, two cans and go, okay, this is what we'll pack in. Play safe.
You can go to the gas station and go buy it by itself. You don't have to buy cases. Go in there and buy the Bud Light, like, blue bottle can or whatever. And, you know, I can drink that down and I'm buzzed for a little bit. And the buzz wears off by an hour or so and drink the other.
Yeah, you know, just, you know, I ain't going to do it, you know. Let you do anything stupid by any means, because I'd be like, I mean, some
nothing
girl wants to.
You could take your $1,400, go get your car. I can hook you up with a car. I can find a car if you want.
Yeah, but see, that's gonna be the. That's why I'm also look. That's why I have $1,000 set back to, you know, another apartment or something, because I'm looking at that way more than a car, because the car has long term shit like gas, oil change. Insurance registration, that shit adds up, and then
that's why you need to move in Tennessee side. You don't have to pay for inspection, you don't pay for a license plate, and you only need tags every once a year, and it's only like $29, and then you get cheap ass insurance.
Yeah, I'll look at that in the long term, but my first objective is, you know, put that $1,000 back to go, okay, I'm going to find me another place to live, you know, so I can get the fuck out of here, because oh, nigger boy, he's been loud as fuck all goddamn day. I actually knocked on the door and they didn't bother answering. I'm like, well, I got that on video. It's getting to the point where he's just doing whatever, so I'm like, you know what? It's a nice house, but it stays cold. I gotta get the fuck out of here. Otherwise, I'm gonna commit murder or wind up dying, so I gotta go.
Yeah, well, the thing is about Virginia inspection, it's like $22 or $21 now there. Used to be 16 back in the day, and then you got to pay for fucking two tags with extras, like $70 or $60 for two Virginia tags. And then you got to pay insurance, and then more time renew your stickers is fucking pain in the ass.
Yeah,
that's really outrageous on Virginia. So,
see, that's what I'm talking about. You know, I've already prioritized it. A stable place to live is way more important than a car right now.
Well, we're gonna get a moped. Get you a moped.
Oh, trust me, I'm working on that.
But the problem about the moped is you might have to take a fucking bike course and not pay ass
nope.
on the Jing side.
Nope.
On the Tennessee side, you don't have to do that.
Nope. I've already looked into it. If it's a 60cc, you don't need a license or anything. Helmet would be common sense, but you don't need a helmet. Now, if it's 150cc, yes, you'll need a driver's license and, you know, tag it, insure it, and all that bullshit.
So I like about down here in Blanco area. You'll get your moped or whatever. If you need a tag, you get a tag for it. But once you pass your car's permit to drive whatever, all you gotta do is just take your moped, just carry it over there and back to the truck or somewhere, take it over to Blanco DMV area, and DMV instructor might be this, watch you. All you do is just park it there, start it up, when instructor there, pull it out. Go down the road, make a right turn, go down, do you eat, come back and park it, you pass. Now, Virginia, they give you fucking football course.
Yeah, you got a parallel park and all that shit. I know all about that. But no, like I said, you know, I got $1,200 already pushed aside, and I've already. I did this while I was waiting on the test results for like 3 hours. I'm sitting there going, okay, $1,400, I broke it down 10 different ways, and I'm like, okay, that's going to leave me with anywhere between $300 and $400 left, so I'm like, fuck it, I'll take the shithead out and, you know, treat them pretty good, and, you know, you help me out, so, you know, fill up your gas tank, and, you know, do all that shit for you, and feed you, and give a little bit of entertainment.
Hey, Robert, you get your date model the other night? Yeah, Robert, you have 8 months yet? Okay, I'll remind you Monday. I'll remind you Monday when you get off work, so you go get it. Well, Well, make sure when you get your vape bottle, make sure you get your nicotine 3. Try that out. That's not the strongest, but, you know, if you're not used to it, that's a bit strong for you. That'll help you relax yourself. Yeah, Steve and I got this fucking weird-ass blueprint yesterday, man.
Yeah! Oh, yeah. Yeah, I was watching the videos. I couldn't find that video, so I had to actually go into your page to find it.
Oh, yeah, me and Steve did, though. When we got that blueprint, we did, like, this fucking long. Somehow, I just ran into that guy.
Yeah, we had a... It was a
it's
piggy
like
bank.
Spree.
Oh, yeah, it was a piggy bank thing, and we went to go check it out, and it was blue. And we're like, what the fuck? Change loadout to that gun.
Demon's game's fucked up. You say that, and that's an update on Warzone. I'm like, okay. No, I'm gonna check my Warzone. I don't have no updates. So I'm like, okay.
I'm thinking somebody fucked with his MAC address or something. Cause something...
Well, he's not the only one. There's three people that have the same issue.
Yeah, that's why I was on by that NASCAR game. So, you know, I'm a good NASCAR driver. I've been playing many games. So,
on the multiplayer, like I said, you're gonna get aggravated with this fucking AI. It's gonna fucking wreck your ass. It's my leggy or something's going on with your car.
Oh, I've had AIs fuck with me nonstop. I'm used to that.
Well, we claim drivers. Robert's a little bit rusty, but once you get a hang of it, easy fucking kick ass.
Oh, I'm a clean as fuck driver. You know, if we're in, like, competition, you know, like team versus team or whatever, third, I don't care. I'll draft the fuck out of people.
Well, what's it called? We got road course. We drive on assist on road course, because it's hard to drive without assist, you know.
Oh, I hate road courses. I hate them with a passion.
Well, if you drive assist, it actually slows the car where you can just fucking drive it just right, King and Robert.
Ah.
Me and this guy, Brendan, he's fucking aggressive on workhorse. He didn't knock your asses. And you have to fight just to get back in first place. We just laugh. Sometimes we just carry on and joke around. We don't take the game too fucking serious, but if people take it too fucking serious, they fucking bitch you out over it.
Yeah, I know people like that.
Yeah, we had shit 2 years of fucking horrible people. So we just had enough, so we just don't pick people that we actually know in person that's really clean and don't give a fuck about it.
Damn.
Wow. Our van's over here too by the airport area. But my safe center to the bounty to clear is to make money off of it. In fact, I was telling Steve when we went to those kill spree yesterday, I said, you don't have to worry about this crate because the people will be working for it and get fucking killed by that motherfucker.
I found a bounty. I just found a bounty back here.
I know it's like a few matches though, they ain't been cut in time. I guess their hack ain't working for the cut time shit. There you go. You die, So don't say it's gone too long because you get kicked out of here. How does that know? Yeah, I just found one for myself. I didn't have one. Yeah, that fucking ass is barely kicking my head. Devin had no fucking sleep, man. He's been up since I went to bed. Seriously. I told Dad, I said, since I lay down, I said, probably I wake up, I'm gonna have a headache, see enough I did. No, my buddy. Well, I'm gonna clean all the bounties out of here so we can make a profit out of that shit.
I just renewed a bounty that I had back here.
I'm going towards the firehouse real quick to clean out that place.
Already cleared out the back area.
I was telling Steve about when you get a crash track and shit, just go over there and not go where the T station is, but go near it where you see the top of the money figure. Just fucking bomb the shit out of the motherfuckers and then pretty sure you get some money. They're busy over there. That's what I'm gonna do when I get done here. Okay.
That was a quickie.
Bounty target identified. Slot the bastard. Hey, we got a drop nearby. That's in quarry though. That's in quarry. I'm gonna grab me a fucking. I'm gonna ride or see. Oh, I say if you pick me up, Steve, we'll go over there. I got fucking plane, whatever. It's got strike. I'm gonna go to the fucking target fucking TV station real quick.
I was gonna pick you up. I was gonna head after that money.
Alright. Well, you're a terrible driver.
No, unlike you, I know how to stay on the fucking road.
Yeah, you don't have choppy chop chop, if you will. And they don't run people over that good.
You too, Arrigan. Hey, look at my gun. It's nice and green in it. Oh, shut the fuck up. Somebody grabbed it.
That's great. Down in green. Go lumber. Alright. Well, we'll get ready. Fucking, before we jump out, we have to fair fight about down there. They are, we can fight for it. Got a vehicle down below. That's it. Just blow it. He's fucking left. Oh, got an enemy nearby. Watch out. That's mine, dude. That's mine. Well, I'm playing fucking landmines here. Casey might run over. He's gonna have to have a vehicle. Let's follow that road down there.
Yeah,
I'm here.
Yeah, I'm here. No way, bitches. No way, bitches. That was priceless. That was fucking priceless. No way, bitches. Hey, what's this? Oh. Okay, you picked it up. That was great. I saw them run toward the car like, no way, bitches. No way, bitches. Oh, God, that was funny as shit. No way, bitches! Oh. See, this is what I love to do, man. We're having too much fun.
Well, we did pass the money.
Well, it left.
Well, we're gonna call back.
I got my radar. They're 40 over here. Oh, he's right there on the side. I'm down. How the hell did I die? Well, I already deposited my money, so he got no money off me. That's if they live.
That's a quarter of money here.
Oh, that was fun while it lasted.
All you gotta do is hit share on your controller and save the video clip. That's all you gotta do. I wish I had some. I don't have any.
Yeah, I'm in here trying to figure out where that little box is. It keeps on whirring. I'm like, where the fuck are you?
Okay, I'm dropping in there by us. Your enemy dropping in.
I marked it.
Yeah, I'm following one up. It's over here where I'm at.
I just unloaded a clip on his ass.
Yeah, he was hacking. He was leg like a motherfucker.
Ah, shit. I thought I had ammo.
There's no one in this area. Just gotta find him. Unless you shot him.
Oh shit, I got a warrant on me. Oh, okay.
I'm gonna spawn a man. I'll check these houses. Oh, starting off drinking?
Oh, got it just in time.
Shit. I said I would start off shit till you guys get into it a little bit and start kicking ass.
Video clip this.